my kingdom to put my hair back and not look like a fucking triceratops. Like, what is happening? I'm coming for you, T-Rex. Hello, beautiful people. Welcome back. So for today's video, we are going to be sitting down and doing a first impression and a wear test on the new IT Cosmetics Your Skin But Better Foundation and Skincare, which I did pick up, as you can tell, in two different shades. I have it in Light Warm 21 and Fair Neutral 11. So I thought we could kind of play around a little with that. Again, do a wear test. Just really zoom the camera in, talk about application, consistency, and obviously how long it wears throughout the day. So if that sounds like something that you're into, give me just a second. I'm going to zoom the camera in, get us out of this little sunshine situation, because as you can tell, I'm filming this at a very awkward time in the morning because here comes the sun, and it's like right in my way. So we're going to be zooming it in and hopefully kind of fixing the lighting, because I'm sure this is just a little bit distracting, but we're going to fix it in just a second. Anyways, really quickly, before we get into the foundation, a couple things to note. My name is Paige. This is Seeking Alexandria. I just want to introduce myself. If you've never been here, welcome to the channel. I upload 3 new videos a week, Monday, Wednesday, Friday, and they normally go up around 7:30-ish a.m. my time here in the good old Northern MI, the Northern Michigan, the Northern Tractorland, or Tractortopia, which I think I'm just going to call Tractopia from now on. Just, you know, I'm trying a rebranding because it's just, it's always loud. There's always noise. And it's just, you know, it's just who we are. But if any of that sounds good, if you like early morning uploads, you like makeup content, weirdness, whatever you happen to see in this video, God only knows what's coming. I can only imagine. Definitely stay tuned. Subscribe. I would love it if you'd stick around, hang out in the comments. And thing number two, and all per usual, the most important, okay? I just really need you to track with me. Follow me on Instagram, okay? Because Instagram and Twitter will both be linked down below. I am way more active over on Instagram. I'm trying to get to 10,000 followers so I can get the swipe up. Really quickly, you know, obviously it can't be forgotten. Those of you that have already done it, I'm kind of sorry, you know, you got to like sit through this spiel in every single video, but thank you for taking the time and already going over there and following me on Instagram. I have noticed a huge jump in the numbers, and it's because of you guys. Like, I can't do this on my own. And the fact that you would take the time out and go do it, and it means a lot to me. So thank you for everyone that has already done it. And for those of you that don't know, or maybe you just aren't, you don't spend a lot of time over there, just a real quick what I do. I put up like funny posts. I love makeup posts, like makeup photos, makeup IGTVs. I do plus size fashion and like try-ons and that sort of thing. And I try to just make it like a platform where there's a lot of everything in terms of the actual content. Then also in my like day-to-day, the Insta stories that you just upload throughout the day, I love to do, you know, PR unboxings or regular, just like what I ordered in the mail unboxings. I hang out, we talk about my dog, life, like whatever the world has going on that day, that is what we talk about. And it's usually just like weird, funny stuff. And just, I don't know, hell, yesterday I talked about like what I did at work, and I showed like a little clip of like my CNC plasma burn table and like custom signs and just a little bit of my life that you guys don't get to see on here. If you ever wanted to know about me and that sort of thing, that is where you'll find it. So anyways, that is the tea. That is the gist of it all. And by the gist, I mean the very long extended version. Yeah, subscribe, turn on your post notifications, follow me on Instagram, and that was a lot. And yeah, let's go ahead, zoom the camera in, and let's get into the video. Okay, you guys, so we're here, we're zoomed in, and now that I got my hair back, it's out of my face, we can just see just all the skin. Let's go ahead and start talking about this foundation. I have it pulled up on the Ulta website, and as I mentioned before, I have this in two different shades. I have Light Warm 21 and Fair Neutral 11, and according to the Ulta website, it says that this is available in 40 options. It retails for $39.50, so just shy of $40. You get one full fluid ounce. And down in the description, it says it's your foundation for better skin. IT Cosmetics Your Skin But Better Foundation is your lightweight, hydrating foundation with a natural radiant finish that gives you beautiful looking skin even on the days you don't wear it. Ooh, so good skincare infusion. I am interested. Experience an instantly better looking complexion and better bare skin in just 2 weeks with Your Skin But Better Hydrating Foundation and Skincare. This buildable medium coverage foundation minimizes the look of pores and imperfections while delivering all day hydration and wear with a natural radiant finish. And then it goes on to say, suitable for all skin types, infused with hyaluronic acid, aloe vera extract, plus vitamins E and B5, your skin loving lightweight foundation goes beyond a tinted moisturizer by working behind the scenes as you wear it. And these right here are the two shades that I picked up. This one is the fair neutral 11, and then this one is the light warm 21. So you can definitely tell that the 21 is warmer and also deeper in tone. All right, so here are the two shade swatches. So we have the warmer one right here, that was 21, and then 11 is this one over here. All right, so this is what they look like separately. I think on camera, it's definitely pulling that the lighter one, number 11, matches me a lot better, especially if you're matching it more, you know, like down to my neck. But I like the warmth that I get from this one up here, from number 21. So I'm just gonna mix them together because I wanna see if maybe I could get like a... Ooh, I like that actually. I like it because it has like the tone or the lightness of number 11, but the number 21 gives it just a little warmth. So I kinda like that mixture actually. Yeah, I think that's what I'm gonna do. Maybe I'll mix like a pump of each. So I'm just going ahead and like wiping everything off so we're good and clean, let that dry. In terms of what I already have on my skin, I just did my skincare. I haven't done primer or anything yet. So for that step, I'm gonna go in with a little bit, if I can find it, hello. Okay, so somehow it magically made its way into my drawer. Like it got put away. I don't know what I was thinking when I did that, bitch. I don't ever put this away. This is my Tatcha Liquid Silk Canvas. And I'm gonna take just one pump of it and work it all over the entire face. All right, and then I'm just going in and I'm mixing one pump to pump ratio with the foundations just to get a nice little mixture here on the back of my hand. And I do like that. I just like the little bit of warmth. Now, obviously, you know, you don't have to buy two shades, mix them and do all this. I'm just doing it because I have them in front of me. So I figured why not create like an undertone and a shade that I like, but again, the shade range does have 40 options in it. All right, so I went ahead and I zoomed the camera in, and I think this will work. Again, the lighting might be a little bit weird at certain points throughout the video, but at this point, we're just kind of used to it. We're used to weird lighting and tractors, guys. It's just what we do around here. Anyways, just getting this foundation worked onto the skin, and oh my word, this looks beautiful right through here, like right in my more textured area. Looks very, very nice, and I am getting like a straight medium coverage, like it indicated in the description, so I'm not mad at that. All right, and then I'm just going through and mixing up a little fresh batch here for the other side, which I'm gonna be applying with a brush. This is the It Cosmetics, what is this? Their Skin Smoothing Complexion Brush right here. It's a beautiful, beautiful foundation brush, very, very soft and silky. And I'm gonna be applying the other side with this one, which, by the way, I think if you order this foundation, and this could have changed, I'm not sure if it was just like a launch special or what, but if you ordered this foundation through It Cosmetics, like their website, I believe you got a free one of these brushes. But if you ordered it through the Ulta website, I believe you also got a free brush. It was also an It Cosmetics brush, but just like a different version. But just so you guys know, if you're looking for a foundation brush, you know, you could definitely check out both of those, see if they're still doing it. I personally really like this brush. I've used it a ton in the past, and it's just... it's a really, really nice, nice consistency, super, super soft. And you know what? As far as this foundation goes, I like it both ways. Like, I like the foundation application with a sponge. I like it with a brush. I'm not having any real issues other than the fact that I totally missed half my forehead. Let's just not talk about it. Okay, let's, don't be rude. Anyways, I think in terms of application, I don't get me wrong, I think it looks good with a brush. Like overall, you know, you can see it applies nice. It has a nice even look to it on the skin. But in terms of the actual like getting up close nitty gritty type feel, I do prefer the sponge just because I feel like I was able to get a more uniform, really pressed in look versus on the brush side. I don't know how well it'll show up on camera, but like right around my nose, my pores look more emphasized. And like I said, you know, probably 52 times at this point, I think it all boils down to the consistency with this foundation because it is so thin. Then I'm just moving through here. This is my Dose of Colors Meet Your Hue Concealer. I have it in the shade 03 Fair. And I'm just using a little bit of that. I really don't need all that much. I feel like I like the medium coverage from this foundation, and it's really melting into the skin beautifully. Like right through here, can you guys see how nice that cheek looks without anything on it? That's impressive. And also one more thing to mention about that foundation that I think could be pertinent. If you pick it up and you're like, oh, you know what? This is my vibe. Like I want to test it out. Be mindful of a couple of things. The consistency of it is very thin. I think I've mentioned that a few times now. And because the consistency is on the thinner side, you do see a greater like absorption with it. So for example, it did settle into the sponge a little bit more, which means the product just doesn't spread around as well before it gets absorbed, whether it's into a sponge or a brush. Like there was a fair amount of settling and absorption either way. And that's not an issue with your application, and I'm just letting you know. It is because this consistency is very thin, it's very runny. This right here is just to kind of show you, like, it's a very runny, very, very thin consistency, and inherently those types of consistencies will, you know, settle in and absorb quicker just because they're more of a water-like consistency. Now I'm gonna go ahead and start setting down the rest of the face, and first up here we're gonna go under the eyes and through the T-zone with my Fenty powder, which I just spilled all over my pants. That's so awesome. This is in the shade Butter. I'm just gonna get this good and packed on here. Oh boy, and I got it all over my shirt. This is just gonna be a powdery kind of fucking day, all right? Toot toot, it's not raining men today, bitch. It's raining powder, and it's raining down on me like I fucking, ooh, like I did something wrong. All right, and now really quick, I wanna take a pause. This is for those of you that, wow, that lighting got drastically different, didn't it? But for those of you that you don't set your foundation, or maybe you have drier skin and you just wanna know kind of how this settles down, I do go ahead on my foundation reviews, and at first I just apply my powder through my T-zone and I kind of lightly block out this area, but I do leave all of this like outer perimeter and through here unset. That way we can do a little bit of a touch test for you guys, kind of see how everything settles down onto the skin, if you need to set it. Actually, you know what, guys? Damn, that actually dries down really nicely. I didn't even think that that was dry because it feels really light and very, very comfortable on the skin, but it's giving me, like, it's dry, like that, wow, that's impressive. It's not like a, like an aggressive, like matte dry down. It's a very nice, almost like a powdery dry down. Like, it's just a nice, light kind of feeling on the skin. And if you don't like to set your face, honestly, I don't know that you'd have to. Like, it feels nice. Again, I'm getting a little bit of transfer, but nothing crazy. And it looks really beautiful. It's not like coming up, you know, in patches or anything. Like, it's not sopping wet. It's not like overly hydrated on the skin. It just looks really, really nice. Okay, I am super impressed right now, because like truthfully, full disclosure, I don't think I've ever had an It Cosmetics foundation that I've actually liked. So like, here's hoping. Oh my God, please tell me I didn't just jinx myself. Oh no. You know what? We're gonna pretend that that was never even said. Okay. Woo, I never said nothing, girl. I love it. What are you talking about? Woo. All right. So moving on, I'm just gonna go ahead now and set the entire face. And for that, I'm gonna use my Too Faced Born This Way powder. This is in the shade Cloud, and I'm just gonna kind of start by tapping over top of the unset areas, a really light little layer of this powder, and then I like to take from there and kind of swiggle in the other powder that I was using, that Fenty powder. Okay, so everything is set down, and I think what's shocking me, or really kind of like catching my attention with this foundation, is how skin-like it really is. Like right through here, I still have a nice medium coverage on my skin, like everything is covered, but I can still see my actual skin peeking through, like just a little redness kind of coming through on both sides, and it's doing it in a very natural-esque way. And I'm very impressed. Like, again, first impression, I think that this looks beautiful on my skin. And I love that it's technically more of like a hydrating foundation, but that it doesn't look overly hydrated on my skin. Anyways, at this point, I'm gonna go ahead, run off of camera, and finish up my face. It's not gonna be anything super in-depth today. And we will go from there, so hang tight, and I'll be right back. And all right, beautiful people, with that, the rest of the face is on and applied. Let's go ahead and throw up the up-close so you guys can see how everything is looking. I think, you know, compared to like now versus when we went off of camera, I think everything looks pretty good. I do think that right now though, I can see just a little bit more heaviness or a little bit more texture, like a little bit more almost of like a matted down consistency over my cheeks. And I don't think it's something like, it's not egregious at all. Like, I don't even know if you guys can see it on camera because it's just that light of a texture, like right in this area on both cheeks, which to be fair, that's not like an uncommon thing for me. I oftentimes have a little bit more of a mattified look right through here just because for some reason, whenever I get done with my makeup, there's always like a little bit of a balancing act that has to happen before all of my foundation kind of melds together. And then right here on the sides of my noses, right on like both sides actually are exactly the same. For some reason, those little crevasses, those are just like the wedgie for foundation. They suck it up there like a vacuum, and there's just like no way around it. Again, in terms of how everything is looking, I think it's right on par with not only a normal foundation, but especially a normal foundation that has more of a skin-like appearance, because these ones aren't really designed to to be like, you know, completely flawless and perfect and this and that, you know. It's meant to give you more of just like that natural skin look, but just more perfected. And that's definitely the vibe I'm getting. I don't think it looks like super fake. I don't think it has, you know, any weirdness going on. I think it's just very normal, very skin-like, which again is exactly what we're looking for. Yeah, in terms of the up close, the foundation, all that good stuff, everything is looking nice. Now, what I am gonna do really quickly, it's not going to be like a super in-depth or a really good up close. I'm just gonna use my phone, but I do wanna shoot over to natural light just so you guys can see how this looks on the skin in that setting as well, because I did have a request in my last video for it. So I'm just gonna go ahead, obviously, and have that overlaid on the screen for you guys, just so you can see like the overall finish, the sheen, the texture, maybe that'll help portray it a little better. Again, I know it's just on a phone, but hopefully it'll be helpful for you guys. From there, I'm gonna go ahead, run off of camera, do the rest of my day. Obviously, I will stop on if anything changes or if, you know, something develops in the situation of foundation, but I'm gonna go ahead, run off of camera, and I'll see you guys after a while. And all right, beautiful people, with that, it is officially the end of the day. Of course, we're here to do our check-in, and we're gonna talk all the good up-close things, see what the foundation looks like, talk about how it wore, the consistency on the skin, all those things. And during the course of today, I was able to really get a good wear and like a good feeling for this foundation. I made sure to go for a few walks, get nice, hot, and sweaty, because y'all, it was like 82, 85-ish degrees today, and let me just tell you, okay, let me just tell you, all right, this Northern Michigan lady, I don't do heat, okay? I do not fuck with the warmth. I do not like it, okay? I do not like it. We are not friends. We are not on speaking terms, especially when there starts being like an 8 in front of it. Get the fuck out of here with that shit. I can't handle. And by the way, can we just pause really quickly? To those of you that like leave down in the comments like, oh, I'm from Arizona, it was 120. I'm in California, I'm here, I'm there. How, like, I physically cannot see or understand or fathom a world in which I would live where it is that hot. Like, what, how? I you know what I see? I picture me just like out on a street somewhere where I'm just like shriveled up like a little raisin, just like not even surviving. I would just, I think I would evaporate, like truthfully, like vampires, how when they see the sunlight, their bodies just like twinkle and then poof, they just like evaporate or ignite or something. I really don't know what happens to vampires because I'm not really up on my vampire information, let's be real. But like, that's what I imagine, okay? I just imagine, poink, and then there I go. Like, where did Paige go? Oh, she's up there now, just floating around, you know, waiting for the sun to go away so she can just settle back into a life form. Anyways, moral of the story here, it got toasty today, and I made sure to take this foundation for a walk. Again, wear my mask, and I'm gonna show that in a minute. We're gonna talk about transfer and all the good things, but let's go ahead first and start off with the up close. So I'm gonna go ahead and get that on the screen for you guys. Overall, with this foundation, I do feel like, again, collectively as a whole, I feel like it wore very, very nicely, especially if you keep in mind that I did wear it for over 11 hours. And this is actually spec'd out as more of a hydrating foundation. Like, if you take all of that into account and my skin type, which is more normal to oily, I am very, very impressed with the wear of this foundation. In terms of like transfer and settling the crevasses, my cracks, like that whole situation, I am seeing a little bit more of like a line development, especially around my mouth, like in my smile lines and the little fine lines that are just around my lips. That whole area did settle a little foundation, which I'm not a fan of, but it also makes sense if you consider like right there is where your mask rubs, you know, it kind of wears the foundation a little bit. So something to consider there. And it's a similar situation up on the nose right through here. I notice a lot of the foundation right here kind of sloughed off. But again, both of those areas are where your mask rides. But again, I just want to keep repeating, like I wore this for 11 hours. So at this point, I'm very impressed actually with how much it didn't break down. I'm impressed that, you know, even as it wore, it seemed to wear off very naturally, which is really, really nice. Like it's not the kind of foundation where it starts to chunk off your skin and like, oh, this spot has none, but this spot has full coverage. Like this seemed to wear very evenly and break apart, you know, more evenly and more naturally, which again, I'm okay with that as long as it keeps that consistency throughout the day. And I really felt like we held on to that. All right, so my apologies on how obnoxiously close this dirty mask has to be to the camera, but the camera won't let me focus on it if it's not. So I just wanna really quickly show you guys, this is the amount of transfer I had. This whole line up here, you can tell this got pretty beat up. This was where my nose was. So that makes sense because this is, you know, my nose is my most oily. So I had a fair amount of oil and transfer up there. And then along the bottom, this right here was where the chin was. And then all through here, you can definitely see, you know, there was a fair amount of transfer from the cheeks and the sides of the face. And now also to go along with this, because I don't think it's fair to just say, oh, I put on a mask, but like not give you any details. So today I wore this. I think I had to wear it twice. place, because obviously you guys know I limit how much I go out into the world. And obviously when I do, I wear my mask, but I try not to go out, so I don't wear it too often. But I was able to wear it. I think I wore it twice today. I made sure to save up my errands just for this video. And I wore it twice. The first time was for maybe a couple of minutes, like 3-4 minutes. And then the second time I put it on, it was for like 15 to 20-ish minutes. And during the second time, I was actually talking, so like there was movement in this area right here. And obviously, like I've said in other videos, you know, this part of the video where I wear a mask, it's not designed to be like, oh, I wore this mask. Let's, you know, this is what happens if you wear it for 8 hours or something like that. Because obviously that's not the case. But it's more so just to show you guys, like, this is how it's going to transfer. This is what to expect. And I just feel like because these are a part of most people's everyday lives, it's still something to know. And actually, you know what? I have one more thing I want to say, just one more, and then I promise I'm done this time. One thing that this foundation kind of reminded me of for a brief second, okay, just like a brief second, was the ColourPop Pretty Fresh Foundation, which I did do a review on this a couple weeks ago. I can link it up here. But in my review for ColourPop, one of the things that I really enjoyed about that foundation was how skin-like it looked and how it really did give me like an effortless, very everyday, like your skin but better kind of vibe. And there were points today with this foundation from It Cosmetics that I did have that same feeling, just like a very, like I've said 100 times, you know, a very nice, natural skin kind of vibe going on. And I kept feeling like this one from It Cosmetics, it's almost what I would say is like an upgraded or like a more foundation version of the ColourPop one. And I don't know if that makes sense, and I don't even know if I'm like articulating this correctly, but there is like some correlation between these two. And I can't quite figure out, like, put my finger right on what it is at this moment, but of course I'll let you guys know, I'll keep you updated as I wear both and kind of compare and contrast the formulas. But I'm just, there's something about this where I don't know if it's like that hyaluronic, like that effortless feeling on the skin, but there is something there. So if you like this foundation, again, the one from ColourPop, if you enjoy that, you enjoy how it looks on your skin, like that more fresh face, that more skin finish kind of feel, I do think that you would enjoy this one from It Cosmetics, because it carries with it that same kind of vibe, but I feel like it does it with a little bit and a little bit more and a little bit better longevity. Because I actually wore this one from It Cosmetics, I wore it longer today, and in my opinion, it did wear better. And it also has a little bit more coverage and a little bit better, just like overall, the way that it wears on the skin is a little bit nicer than the one from ColourPop. Again, that's just kind of from memory comparing. I haven't obviously done like a direct comparison between the two. So I'm definitely going to keep you guys posted on that, let you know what I think there. But you guys, like I said, from there, I'm done. I promise I'm going to stop talking. Let me know all of your thoughts and opinions down in the comments. Whether you were curious about the foundation, you don't care about it, you just like foundation reviews, you just like videos in general, whatever the case may be, let me know all of your thoughts and opinions down in the comments. I would love to hear from you. And of course, like I said at the beginning, if you haven't done so yet, please don't forget you can subscribe, turn on your post notifications down below. And of course, a horse is a horse, of course. I'm not sure what horses have to do with following me on Instagram, but like, you know what, if that's what it takes, guys, if that's what it takes to get you to follow me over there, if you like horses, follow me on Instagram, okay? Just like do the thing, just do the damn thing, okay? Follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. They will both be linked down below. Thank you guys again all so, so much for watching. Please don't forget to have an amazing day, night, weekend, whatever it is when you're watching this, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Oh, have you ever wanted to go put your hair up and like right at the nape of your neck, like right here, there's like a tiny little snarl, and of course it's the teeniest little snarl in the whole fucking world, and you get your finger caught in it, and then you go to put your hair up because you're just like, oh wow, like tresemme, ooh la la, and you put your fingers through your hair, and then before you know it, you're ripping out a whole little tuft, and you're just like, because you had a snarl and you didn't know it was there. Oh my god. So painful. My kingdom to put my hair back and not look like a fucking triceratops. Like, what is happening? I'm coming for you, T-Rex! That was me pecking, using my beak to peck, to peck at Core. Because, can't you tell I'm a chicken with my fucking gobbler up here? No, wait, a gobbler's down here. With my crown. I think it's actually called a crown. Look at me being Northern Misha fucking Gander. Northern Misha Gander. This is a crown? I call this a gobbler? I don't know. Actually, I call this a chalupa chin, but on a chicken, I call it a gobbler. Paige, stop it right now. Nobody cares about your perceived anatomy of a chicken. Wow, what kind of a beauty channel am I? Like, what do other people talk about? I should probably watch a booty channel. A booty channel. I should watch a booty channel. Legs asleep. Oh, it's asleep bad. Why is it asleep? Oh, probably because I held it at a 90-degree angle and I'm 77 years old. Oh, I need to, like, stretch out my hips. Okay. Ooh. Bring that pelvis around town, honey. Bring it around. Bring your pelvis around town. That, ma'am, you sound a little promiscuous.
Promiscuous girl, I'm all alone, and it's you that I want. Promiscuous boy,
wow. I never learned the words to that song because I didn't like it. I didn't want to commit anything to memory. Also, why do I still have my Triceratops horn?
Look at how cute my shirt is. My shirt is, so cute. It's from Torrid. I'll link it down below. It is satin. Ooh, it's got lace. Uh-huh. I'm gonna link it. Uh-huh. In your face.
Paige, go to bed.